Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today, we are going to go over 10 tips for using email in Microsoft Outlook. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description. So my first tip is going to be how to turn off notifications about new emails. Sometimes these notifications are really helpful, but sometimes it's just too much and they're going off all the time. So how do you turn those off? If you go up to File and go down to Options, there's a section here called Mail. And if you look down here with Message Arrival, there's a couple different things that can happen when a message arrives. You can have it play a sound, change the mouse pointer, show an envelope down in the taskbar, or display a desktop alert. If you uncheck all of those boxes, you shouldn't get any more notifications for when you receive an email. And then just hit OK after you update those checkboxes. Tip number two is how to find messages related to the one that you are looking at right now. So in some cases, there has been an email chain going back and forth on a certain message, but when you look in your inbox, you don't have them grouped together, so you would like to see all the messages relating to this one subject. So if you right click on any message and go to Find Related, messages in this conversation or messages from sender, you will see all the messages that went back and forth on this subject. Tip number three is to create quick steps. If I wanted to do the same task over and over again with certain messages, I could select that message, go up here, and add a new quick step. And in this case, I'm going to add a new quick step to move to folder, and I'm going to move this to a folder called From Me and say Finish. So now, anytime I click on a message that I would like to move, all I have to do is hit From Me up here for all of these messages. And when I go into the From Me folder, I will see all those messages have been moved really quickly. So that is called Quick Steps up here on the Home tab. Another helpful tip is to create a signature. So if I go to Create New Email, you can see down here that I have a signature on this email so that I don't have to take my name and my contact information over and over again. So if I would like to edit that, or if I would like to insert a signature for the first time, I would go up here where it says, tell me what you want to do, and type in signature and go to signatures. And you can see here that I can edit my signature. So let's say I'm going to put my phone number in and my email. And if I say okay, it won't take effect for this message, but if I close this message down and I go to a new email, you will see that all my new information for my signature has been added. The next tip is setting up an out-of-office message. So if you know you're going to be going on vacation, but you might be receiving emails during that time, you can set up a message to automatically send back to the sender of your messages to say, hey, I'm out of the office for a week, just to let the person who's sending the email know not to expect a quick response. So in order to do that, just go up to File and go to Automatic Replies. And right here, you can have an automatic reply and you can set a date range and say, I am away until 3/8. And up here, you can make sure the date goes to 3/7 because that's the day before you're coming back. And if I say, okay, anyone sending me an email during this time period up here will get an automatic message that says whatever I have typed in here. So just say okay to enable that. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos. If you would like to delay delivery on creating an email, just go up here to New Email and go up here and type delay, and you'll get this option for delayed delivery. And right here, you can check this box that says do not deliver before and set a date and a time. So this will now not be delivered to this person until March 8th at 5 p.m. So just hit close on that and put in your email address and a subject and hit send. Now, if I go down here to my outbox, I will see that that message is still sitting in there. So I can actually delete it before the send deadline that I had set up if I change my mind and I end up not wanting to send it. The seventh tip is how do I check more than one email using Microsoft Outlook? If I go to File and I go to Account Settings, I can see that I have one email set up here, but I can actually add another email account. So if you have a Gmail account or an iCloud account and you would like to check all of your email in one place, you can use Outlook to do that. So to start that, you just hit New and you will be taken through a wizard to be able to set up this new account to be checked in Outlook. And when that new account is created, you will have another down arrow like I have right here for checking that new account. For the eighth tip, I would like to draw your attention to these numbers over here. I can see that I have one unread deleted item because of this bolded one right here. But I also have a number two right here for my outbox, and that means I have two messages sitting in my outbox. So what I would like to know is how many emails do I actually have in each one of these folders? So if I right-click a folder and I go to Properties, and right here, instead of checking show number of unread items, I can hit show number of total items and say okay. So for that folder, I can now see how many total messages I have in that folder. Tip number nine, if you receive an email and you'd like to quickly add this person to your contacts, just go into the body of the email and see their initials here, right click and hit add to Outlook contacts, and you will be brought up to the contact screen, and you can just edit more details here if you would like to, and just hit save and close at the end, and that person, if you go to contacts, will now be in your contacts. And tip number 10, this actually comes from other Microsoft Office applications. So if I were to go into Excel and I had a spreadsheet open, I can simply go to File, Share. I can attach this to an email either as an Excel workbook or as a PDF. So if I hit Excel, you can see right there that my email is going to automatically attach this file, and I'll just send it to the recipient and hit Send. And I can do this from Excel, PowerPoint, Word, etc. So those are the top 10 Outlook email tips that I have for you. Join us next time for our top 10 calendar tips that we have. Hope you learned something new today, and see you again next time. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.